Well, hello, and welcome to my backyard. Today we're going to be basting our quilts. And so I have always had trouble with pinning my quilts, and I tried basting it, and that is spray basting, and I have loved it and haven't gone back. I have my spray adhesive from, this one's from Joann's. They sell them at quilter shops also. I use that mostly. I didn't have any, and I had to go to Joann's yesterday evening to get some for today. So I have my quilt back ready. I have my quilt top ready, and I am doubling my batting to give it a little extra fluff. So I have that ready too. I put washi tape in the middle of my table. It's not the exact middle. It's just kind of a point of reference to try to aim for all the layers going on top of each other. So I'll put a pin in all the different layers, and I'll try to kind of line those pins up. I might stray because I want to have this close to the edge, this block close to the edge, so I might kind of change it up a little bit. Sorry if I do. The reason why I do this way is because I don't care to crawl on the ground and try to, you know, stretch everything out. I have tile floors, so in ways it's harder for me, I guess, just because how hard the floors are. But so I don't like crawling on the floor, and I don't do quilt yoga. I do yoga, just not quilt yoga. And let's see, let's just get started and see how this goes. Okay. So first I'm going to find my center and put a pin in it. And the pins should go on the outer layer, so you can pull the pins out. If you have the pins in the inner on the seam side and forget to take it out, you're gonna have a pin in your quilt. Oh, that's not good. So I hope you guys are enjoying the quilt along. I sure am. I can't wait to quilt this bad boy. And this is my second take, so my pin is already in here. Now, I don't know if you can see, but I have a little cute little French bulldog washi tape on the table already. It's black. And I'm doubling up, so this is the half of that, and this is the half of that. All right. So, first thing we do is we put the quilt bottom down. So I'm going to feel it and see the tape. So that's good. And there's about the same amount of distance on each side of my table, so that's good. So the seams have to go up because you don't want the seams on the outside. So now I'm going to take my batting and I might adjust a little bit. Center. the one that you are going to want to take out right away, is the pin in the batting. So, and it's not going to cover that whole block, so I'm going to move it over. I'm going to go rogue. And, you know, this is just something I enjoy. I take my time. I make sure all my layers are nice and flat. And I think it's an enjoyable process. Okay, so I'll take this pin out. Don't forget that. And let's see, my lady, her head is here, her eye is here, so I want to mimic that on the top. Once I get to this point, I will pull layers up, spray, and then pull them back down and make sure that they're nice and flat. So I'll take the pin on the top out, and let me get my spray adhesive. All right, everybody, we're back and ready to go. What I do is I flip over my top, and I kind of protect the tops of the fabric. So all my seams are showing, but the actual fabric isn't showing. So I don't really want to spray directly on the quilt. I want to keep my spray on the stuff that's going on the inside. So I always try to spread out my layers as well as possible. See if I am going to need to pull everything off. See, there's my seam. Thank you. much better. Okay, so now we can start. You want to, I probably spray about 10 inches or so away. Give it a good dusting, especially where your quilt is folded up and over. And I've got one layer back. Protect the top and make sure everything lays nice and flat. And this is the most important part, is getting it nice and flat. Okay, just going through every space, every inch, every half an inch, spreading it out, making sure that you don't have any puckers. I'm just gonna pull the quilt over and do the same thing. And it'll tell you, kind of just pulls, it'll tell you where you sprayed. Kind of want to have gentle hands and let your fabric kind of talk to you and tell you. Voila. I like to give a little extra spray on the edges where it's going to lay, because I find that sometimes I'm like, ah, it's not sticking. So I'll even go over a little bit closer, trying to avoid the fabric as much as possible on the top. Sometimes I do, sometimes I don't. I might add a few pins because I did double up my batting. I think I will add pins. And then I'll do it on the other side. And that will be interesting because I'll be facing the back. The camera will be facing my back. So we'll see if that is just horrible. Maybe I'll take it out. All right, so we're done. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope it was helpful. If you have any questions, let me know.